Okay, so in exercise 16, we're going to look at equations where you might have to use identities to solve. So solving trig equations, same thing as we did in exercise 12. This time, since we know how to use identities, we're going to use identities to solve them. So what situations would this have to happen? Well, if the angles aren't the same, there's a case here. Look, this is sine of double of the angle, and this is sine of the angle. Those angles aren't the same. So for example, if theta was 20 degrees, this would be 20, and this would be 40. So you're going to use identities there. Or if you cannot factor, often that's the case where, for example, there's sine and cos in there, can't factor. So it might be necessary to use identities to solve an equation. Example one. So again, the angles aren't the same, but we do have an identity that can change this expression, sine 2 theta, into only theta, right? And that comes from, again, your formula sheet. So sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta, and that's equal to sine theta. And now what I can do is I can bring this to the other side and make equal to 0 on one side. So you have 2 sine theta cos theta, bringing it over to the other side, so minus sine theta equals 0. And now in this situation, we can factor the common factor of sine, and we're going to get an expression we can solve. So, or an equation we can solve, I should say. So sine theta, 2 cos theta minus 1 equals 0. And this gives us two equations, sine theta equals 0, and 2 cos theta minus 1 equals 0. So we have sine theta equals 0. So that's one equation. And we have 2 cos theta minus 1 equals 0. I can solve this quickly, and I get cos theta equals 1 half. Okay, so now I want to solve for the interval 0 to 2 pi, including both values. So for sine theta equals 0, so again, imagine your little unit circle. Sine theta equals 0 on those two spots. It's when y equals 0, right? So we're going to have theta equals to 0 pi and 2 pi, because don't forget, 2 pi is part of the answer. So that would be the solution for this part of the equation, so this branch. And on this side, in this branch, cos equals 2 a half. Well, that's an exact value. That's exactly on your unit circle at a couple spots. So this is x is equal to a half. So this is pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3. So this would be the solution on that side. So the solutions for this equation, so the values of theta that solve this equation would be 0 pi, 2 pi, and also pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3, which would solve that problem. All right, next one, determine the non-permissible values of the following equation. So there's always non-permissible values that you cannot include. And here, we wouldn't have any non-permissible values on that side because you're just dividing, you're never dividing by 0. But on this side, since tan is sine theta over cos, right? So maybe I'll write the first line of this equation. So we have sine theta over cos theta equals sine 2 theta. Well, notice that this has a non-permissible value. Therefore, cos theta cannot equal to 0. And if we're going on that interval, again, cos is equal to 0 here and here. Therefore, theta cannot equal to pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So this is all we're saying is that if these solutions come up on the equation as possible solutions, we will have to remove them as possible solutions. Okay, so now B, it's asking to solve the equation over the given interval. So we want to solve this equation. Notice that this will be the first step because look at it, we have theta and 2 theta. You want to have the same angle, so just theta in your question. So you're probably going to have to change sine into 2 sine theta cos theta. So step here would be sine theta over cos theta. So that's the left-hand side, right? So that's tan theta. And on the right-hand side, we're going to use the identity, which we already used earlier in the other example, here. Okay, well, we kind of have to do the same thing. So I have to make equal 0 on one side. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this denominator, cos theta. So I'm going to multiply by cos theta on both sides. So times by cos theta. And what we're left with is sine theta equals to 2 sine theta cos squared theta, right? Because you multiplied cos times cos. This is one term, so this just multiplies that. And then here, cos thetas cancel out. Okay, so I'm going to do something very similar. I'm going to bring that to the other side. Don't forget, anytime you want to solve an equation, you always want equal to 0 on one side. So equals to 0, we have 2 sine theta cos squared theta minus sine theta. Okay? So now, again, similar to the last example, I'm going to factor the common factor of sine. So as soon as we factor, we can produce some equations. Oops, this is cos squared theta minus 1. Okay, so sine theta is factored out. We divide that by sine theta, it's 2 cos squared. Divide that by sine theta gives 1. This gives us two solutions, or two branches, I guess. You'd have sine theta equals 0, and you'd have 2 cos squared theta, whoops, this is squared, minus 1 equals 0. Okay, so this side's pretty easy. Sine theta equals 0. Notice that the interval was 0 to 2 pi, but we don't include 2 pi in this case. So theta would be equal to 0 and pi. Those are no problems. Those are possible solutions. On this side of the equation, we're going to have to do a little bit of solving first. So I'm going to bring the 1 over, divide by 2. So you're going to have cos squared theta equals to 1 half. You're going to square root both sides here, right, to get rid of that square. So therefore, you're going to have cos theta equals to plus or minus 1 over square root of 2. Don't forget, when you take the square root of 1, it becomes 1, and the square root of 2 is just square root of 2. Okay, so there's actually two different equations here, and I'm going to try to put this all into one space here. So we're going to have two different equations. We're going to have cos theta equals to positive 1 over square root of 2, and cos theta equals to negative 1 over square root of 2. All right, if you notice this value, you might have recognized it. 1 over square root of 2 is actually, if you were to multiply by square root of 2 over square root of 2, it would give you square root of 2 over 2. Well, that's the same value as that. So we know that those values. When is cos equal to square root of 2 over 2? Well, that is simply when we have pi over 4, first quadrant, and cos is positive in the fourth quadrant. So these would be the other two solutions. And on this side, well, that would be the second and third quadrant. Again, this is an exact value. It's negative square root of 2 over 2. So we'd have theta equals 3 pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4. Again, I recommend you take a look at your unit circle if you're not sure, and it should solve the problem for you. Okay, so now just going back, I don't know if all these numbers will move with me. Oops, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay, so they didn't. Notice that none of these are non-permissible values, right? So we can accept all of these different solutions presented here. So these are all the solutions to that equation. All right, so a few more examples. So solve the equation over this interval. So we just want the first revolution solutions. Notice that we have cos 2x plus 1 equals to cos x. Those two angles are not the same. So we're going to have to change this. We have identities from your formula sheet where we can change cos 2x. We have choices here. But because we already have cos in the equation, we're going to choose the identity that only has cos as part of this identity. So for cos 2x, we're going to choose 2 cos squared x minus 1. So that's the value of cos 2x. So we have plus 1 equals to cos x. Okay, so then we're going to simplify from this position. Notice that these brackets don't make a difference. I put brackets to represent cos 2x, but there's nothing in front, so it doesn't change. So really, we have 2 cos squared x minus 1 plus 1. So I can simplify that to 2 cos squared x equals to cos x. And we have something very similar to the last page. So we're going to bring this cos x over here. Don't forget, we want equals to 0. So 2 cos squared x minus cos x equals 0. And again, very similar, we have a common factor of cos. So we have cos x, and what we left here is 2 cos x minus 1. So I just factored out the common factor of x. We're going to have cos x equals 0 as one branch, and we're going to have 2 cos x minus 1 equals 0 as our second branch, which we can solve for cos x as cos equals 1 half. All right, so then all we have to do is solve those two equations. Notice that these are all exact values from your unit circle. Cos equals 0 at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So that'd be the solutions for the left-hand branch over here. And then for the right-hand branch, cos equals to 1 half. Well, we've actually solved that exact same problem somewhere else in these notes. It's pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3. So this would be quadrant 1 and quadrant 4 because cos is positive. All right, next one. So notice that we have cos squared here and sine x. That's not a good situation to be in because you can't factor cos and sine in the same equation. But we do have an identity here for cos squared x that we can replace cos squared with sine. And if you remember, if you take a look at your Pythagorean identities, we know that sine squared x is equal to 1 minus cos squared x. Well, this is actually exactly here. Notice that we have 1 minus cos squared x. Well, that value can be replaced with sine squared. And if I have sine already in my equation, I would like to have sine everywhere in the equation. So I'm going to replace this with sine squared x. So what we have left is sine squared x equals to 3 sine x minus 2. All right, so now our problem is we need to bring all the terms to the same side. We need equals 0 on one side so we can factor the other. I'm going to move everything over here because here this is our largest degree, sine squared, and it's a positive coefficient. So everything on the left-hand side will look like this. Right, so you subtracted 3 sine x to get to this side. You added 2 to get to that side. So now we have a trinomial here that we need to factor. Not extremely hard one to factor. So we know that to get sine squared, you're going to have to do sine times sine. And the terms in the middle, okay, a little bit of effort. Two terms that multiply to a positive and add up to a negative. So you're going to have negative 2 and negative 1. So negative 2, negative 1 gives you negative 3. Negative 2 times negative 1 gives you positive 2. Okay, so we have two equations here. We're going to have sine x equals 2, and we're going to have sine x equals 1. Kind of skipped a half step there. And next, we're going to have to solve these two equations. So notice on the left-hand side here, sine x is equal to 2. I'm sure we've discussed this at this point, but sine's maximum value is 1, and minimum value is negative 1. Okay, because think, the ratio of opposite over hypotenuse cannot be larger than 1. So on this left-hand side, we have no solution. So there's no value of x that would give you an answer here. But sine equals to 1, well, that's an answer we have from the unit circle. Think about where is sine equal to 1. Well, it'd be right here at the top. So our only solution would be pi over 2. So the only solution to this problem right here would be x equals pi over 2. Okay, for this next example, I want to make reference to that formula sheet. I just took a little snippet of your formula sheet here. The one line I want to look at is this line right here. Because if you look at the question, we have secant squared and we have tan. Well, I can't change tan into secant, but I can change secant squared into tan using this formula. So it would look a little bit like the last example. So notice that here is secant squared. If I change it into tan squared plus 1, this question would only have the tan function inside of it. So that's what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to change secant squared into, so I'm replacing secant squared with tan squared theta plus 1, and then minus 1 equals to 3 tan theta. So notice that now I only have tan theta part of this equation, and that's the idea. You want to change all your trig functions to the same trig function with the same angle. And that's what we have here. Okay, so a little bit of work left to do. We're going to distribute this 2. Whoops, wrong button. Distribute this 2. So we have 2 tan squared theta plus 2 minus 1 equals to 3 tan theta. Right, so I distributed the 2 into that bracket. And then I'm going to bring everything over to this side because the leading coefficient of tan squared is positive. So I'm going to bring this over, and I can also simplify those two terms. So we have 2 tan squared theta minus 3 tan theta plus 1 equals to 0. Okay, well, this is a trinomial, again, that we need to factor. Well, I'm sure we'll talk about factoring in class at some point in exercise 12. It's coming back again. So I'm looking for two terms that multiplies to 2 tan squared. Well, that has to be 2 tan, whoops. Not squared, 2 tan times tan theta. So multiply those together, you get 2 tan squared. And then you need to have these two terms multiply it up positive 1 So we know that it has to be two negatives to get a negative in the middle and a positive on the outside. And just to check, this gives us negative 2 tan, and this is getting negative 1 tan. Together it gives us negative 3. Okay, so we have two equations we can solve for here. We have tan theta equals to positive 1 half. Again, I just made this equal to 0 and then solved. And then we have tan theta equals to 1. Okay, well, this one, a little bit easier because it's an exact value. So on your unit circle, where is tan is equal to 1? Well, that is being the first quadrant because tan is positive, so pi over 4. And the third quadrant, which is 5 pi over 4. Whoops, 4, not 3. Okay, so that'd be the solutions for this branch of the equation. Now this one requires us to do a little bit of work, so we're going to have to find the angle of reference. So the angle of reference will be equal to the inverse tan function of a half. And the angle of reference, again, plug that into your calculator. And don't forget, your calculator must be in radians. Your angle of reference will be 0.4636. And again, I'm going to truncate to 4 decimals. And we're looking for a solution where tan is equal to positive a half, which means tan is positive in quadrant 1 and 3, very similar to what we saw here. So to find the first quadrant, well, it's simply the angle of reference, right? So that's the first quadrant solution. And then now, in the third quadrant, we simply have pi plus our angle of reference, which is 4636. And therefore, again, plug that into your calculator, and you get 3.6051. So again, I just truncated to the fourth decimal. All right, so for this last one, I think we'll just to shorten up the video. We'll probably do this one in class just to give you guys a little bit more practice in class. You guys can try it out yourselves if you like. I think it's a very valid question to start you off. Probably what you want to do is change that into a sine function so that way you have sine everywhere. Okay, good luck, guys. Hope this exercise made sense.